his hand. Yeah. Remember? The hammers. It is IJ Hark, the Queen of Hearts, and I am back with another video, y'all. I'm feeling really, really, really witchy today. Witchy and bitchy. A little bit of bitchy, okay? A lot of witchy. Because we are reviewing the Moon Spell Collection by Lunar Beauty, and it's just so amazing. Like, oh my god, like this whole palette, the details that you pay, it just feels like you're holding a fucking book. So if you guys want to see what I think of these products and the Moon Spell Collection, then just keep on watching. Before we get into the video, guys, please, please, please do not forget to hit that subscribe button and join the coven, okay? Join the little coven, the Royal Flush, whatever you want to call it. And right after you hit the subscribe button, there is a gray bell notification right after that. Please click that to be notified for my future videos. And at any point in this video, you guys are enjoying me, you guys enjoy witches, you guys are enjoying this collection, then give this video a big, 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 wicked thumbs up. And with that being said, y'all, let's just get into this video.
That's the reason we do this. Baby, you better use it. Use your imagination.
Imagination. I'm this combination of the Born This Way and the W Air Fit primer. That video reached 10k views, y'all, in 3 months. 10k views. What the heck? All because of this primer. 10k views. So I've been using the Too Faced, what is it called? What's that shit called? Their serum that they came out with? Like, their hydrating serum with hyaluronic acid in it. And I used all that up in like a month. So I had to go buy me another one, because I actually love that product. Take a little translucent powder and just set my face. Y'all already know the deal. I'm about to go in with the Juvia's Place, and I'm in the shade Havana. Ooh, Havana, na-na. I probably put too fucking much, but, ooh, this is thick. This is my first time trying this, and I did shade match myself. So let's see how this is about to go. This is thick. Y'all, this is like thick like peanut butter. Say Havana, oh na na. Half a month.
Bitch, what the fuck?
This is too dark for me. Why do I always get shit that's too dark for me? And this is red. Ooh. Yo, we got to make this work. This is full coverage. This is red as fuck on me. Why would I get this shade? I was better off letting the Sephora, letting the Ulta Girl shade match me. Y'all, this is orange. This is orange. I'm about to go in with the Morphe concealer. I'm not about to put too much because I heard some. It did kind of remove. I'm taking my Too Faced concealer just to add that a little bit more under my eye, just for extra coverage. Cause I can still see my dark circles. So I'm gonna go in with my ABH eyeshadow primer. And y'all know I'm a eyes before base kind of bitch, but I just wanted to do my base first for the sake of this video. And I have to just do one eye first and then do the other one off camera. I have to go in with the palette. Oh my God. Y'all, I'm super excited for this, y'all. Like, look. So basically the whole intention for this palette was to be like a grimoire, just like you were a witch or anything like that. So, you know, cause he said he grew up off that type of stuff. So did I. I love witch, anything witch, warlock, a vampire, anything supernatural. I love it and live for it. So it's literally just like a book. You take it out of the sleeve, just like a book. And this is so, it feels just like a book too. Like it looks like a book, like the little ridges on the side, literally just like a little book. It feels like a book too. Like it's so cool. And I'm gonna keep this cause this looks really amazing. I don't know what I'm gonna use that for, but I'm gonna keep it. So this is the moment of truth. So I'm feeling like a purple look. So I'm gonna take this shade Sabrina, the darkest purple in here. And I'm gonna take that and pat that right in my inner corner. Ooh. I also own one of his, I own Life's a Drag too. And I wonder if Pageant Queen, I think that's what that's called, man, if that's just as pigmented as this. Or not just as pigmented, but if it's close, the colors. So far I'm not having any troubles with anything, but you know, only use one thing. And of course I use the best eyeshadow primer on the market, which is the AVH. I'm taking the shade Paige, and I'm just taking that to blend out that purple and diffuse the edges of that purple a little bit. Ooh, Paige is a pretty color. I feel like a color like this is really good for blending out purples anyway, like, you know, like just like a lighter pink purple. I'm just taking Sabrina back and just bringing her back, bringing that color right back. I'm about to cut my crease and I'll be right back. I think I'm gonna put Samantha all over my lid. Samantha or Phoebe. But Phoebe, if y'all ever use the James Charles palette, like, not even to talk crap about it, Phoebe looks like the purple James created. Like, I don't know. Maybe he got inspiration from it. But so far, that crease looking cut, period. I'm going to go in with Prue on my eyes. Prue, don't let me down. Okay, that's pretty now. Ooh. So I wish this palette had a deeper purple. Then I would say this palette will be everything. So this is the Morphe 35B. And I wish they had like a really deep purple like this right here. And this is like just a really deep purple. So this shade right here, the 35B, is more of like Sabrina. I don't know why it's picking up lighter on camera, but it's not that light. So let me swatch Sabrina. On camera, Sabrina looks really light, but it's not that light. And this is the dark, deeper purple in the 35B. Okay, guys, so I'm going to do the other eye off camera, and I'll be right back. Okay, my eyes are done. Took way longer than expected, but We got them done. And I'm moving back onto the face. I'm going to take my Sephora Micro Smooth. It's this. Take that and just dust off this bake. I've been baking for like 30 minutes straight. I don't know if it's the foundation or what, because this shit is separating on my nose. I know it's the foundation, does anything else, but this is separating on my nose and on my mouth right here. So, yeah. I don't know what that's about. I'm not really doing too much with my makeup. I'm just going to take some bronzer, which is my, of course, my lip bar bronzer. And I'm using that to contour, bronze, whatever, and add warmth to my face. Ugh, that looks so pretty. I like using this as a contour slash bronzer because it just looks so pretty on its own. So, and I know Jackie uses this as a bronzer, but y'all have to realize that y'all probably like, oh bitch, that's too dark for you. But Jackie, she like using bronzers that are closer to her skin tone than opposed to something that's darker or warmer than her skin tone. So, but this is a really cute bronzer. I love it, and the blush. The blush is amazing as well. Going to go in with my Color Rain Power Blush Duo. The blush is really pretty in here. I love that I could just skip the step of contouring and everything. It just saves time with that blush bronzer from the lip bar. And this blush is very, very pretty. I want to reinforce that bake. Gonna take a little MAC Fix Plus. Then a little Too Faced Hangover Watermelon Extract. Taking the highlighter in the Power Duo. Bitch, that's pretty. Now taking the new Fenty Beauty Diamond Balm, which is Hollow Acne. About to take that and just apply that everywhere. Y'all know I love the Diamond Balms, so, cause they're da bomb, okay, period. A little bit right there. So when I look for it, you know, that's right there, that little cute little perk like that. Like, you know, I just like to take it on a big brush because I don't really like to be precise with this because it's so sheer. It's like a sheer little glow. So it's like, you don't even need to be precise with this thing. Now I'm going to take some Anastasia Dewy Set and just so my skin looks really good. Like, whew, we're almost done. But Bonnie on top of Marnie and Nancy to like just brighten them both up, and it actually turned out really, really cute. I'm definitely doing a wing, period. You have to do a wing with this type of look, like you have to. So my lips are kind of dry, so I'm going to take this lip scrub by Glosses Poppin', okay, by Skylar. Thank you so much, Skylar, for gifting me this. And I'm trying out the lip scrub because it's my first time. I mean, it's not my first time trying out a lip scrub, but I'm just about to try out the lip scrub. My lips are dry. And it's not bad tasting. It's like, how does it taste? I'm actually glad they gave me this because it's like a sugar lip scrub too. I really enjoyed the lip scrub. Thank you so much again, Skylar. It really did its job. My lips are really smooth and nice. And she also gifted me glosses too that I'm going to try out later on in the video after I swatch these lippies. So his collection came out with 3 lippies. I'm just taking them out the box for you guys so I can swatch the... So his collection came with 3 liquid lipsticks. These are my first time trying out his liquid lipsticks. And I mean, it didn't come out with 3. It came out with 2 liquid lipsticks and 1 gloss. Oh, this smells so good. The gloss smells so good. It's called Enchantment. It smells like cupcakes. The first one I'm going to try out is Wicked because I love a black. So I'm going to take that out. Doe foot wise, it is a pretty neat doe foot. It's a nice point. So let me see if I can easily get my lips. Hey guys, so let's just get into the products, you know, the final breakdown, what I think about this whole collection, the whole holiday collection from Luna Beauty. Now, so the only product besides this new collection that I've just purchased that I own from Luna Beauty is Life's a Drag. I got that when it first dropped last year. Last year. And they came out with two other collections after that. Well, three, including Moonspell, which is the Greek Goddess collection and then the Strawberry Dream collection. And I have Moonspell because I love witches. I love anything concerning witches. I've watched them all. Every show or movie that were inspired by this collection, I've watched all of them. And he also forgot to mention, what did he forget to mention? He forgot to mention Twitches, and I forgot the other show that he actually forgot to mention that is like witch themed. So first I want to talk about the palette, of course, the Moonspell palette, which is a colored palette. It's not an eyeshadow palette, it is a colored palette, and it just looks so freaking pretty. Like, it just looks so cute. And the shade names, of course, is a key. Like, I just love the shade names, you know, of course. So the eyeshadows, period, they blended like a dream. They blended like I thought they would, which, like, you know, I always have high expectations when it comes to eyeshadow palettes. But, you know, there are some eyeshadow palettes that just amaze me in general, like, you know, just blow my mind away, and this is one of them. Like, I use Sabrina Page and Prue. And I also use Bonnie, Marnie, and Nancy. And they all blended amazingly. I put Marnie, Nancy, and Bonnie up under my eye down here. And I put Paige, Prue, and Sabrina on my lid and up here. And everything just blended amazingly. I have no complaints. The packaging is so, so cute. Like, I can see myself using this again. I will actually be using this in my next video, because this video is going up Monday and my next video is going up Wednesday. So I'll also be using this palette again in there, but I'm going to be using mostly greens in that one since I use purples today. I can't wait to use like almost every shade in here because like everything was amazing. The only bad thing I can say is that Prue, it kind of crumbled. Like, when I was putting her on my lid, she just wasn't, at first she was just wasn't giving me life or giving me what I needed from, you know, like a shimmer shade. But after I packed it on with my finger and everything like that, it turned out really, really cute. And I actually really enjoyed Prue, but it kind of crumbled. Like, it crumbled when I was going digging in with the brush. It kind of crumbled, and that's not really cute. Maybe because it's just so soft. I also love the big mirror in here too. Too bad I cannot peel this shit off because I have long ass nails. Actually, let me try. Oh, I can. So yeah, like, I just really, really love this whole collection. This palette is amazing. Like, oh, it's so good. I really, really love this. I will be using this a lot. Like, I can see myself using this a lot. Now let's get into the Lippity Doodahs. I have all three. I don't know where the black one is. I don't know where the black one is, and I have the black one on my lips. I really don't know where it is. So I have the shade Witch Bitch and Enchantment, and I love the name Witch Bitch. Like, it's just a key. Like, I really love it. If you know where it's from, Witch Bitch has been said a lot in mainstream media, like, for years. So it's just such a cute name. It's such a pretty shade too. Let me show y'all. Oh my god, it's literally like a blood red. Oh my god, look at that. So pretty. I didn't want to wear it today because I just wanted to go, you know, just wear a black shade and, you know, just to bring out my inner witchiness, you know. And this is the shade Enchantment, which is a gloss. And this is what I have on my lips right here, like this shade right here. It has a purple dual chrome to it, and it added such a cute, like duochrome purpleness to my black lip. It's creamy, it's comfortable. The packaging of this, like, Manny, if you're watching this, you really paid to like attention to detail when it comes to your packaging, period. It's just astonishing. Like, this whole collection is just amazing, and I really, really love it. I can see myself using all three of these liquid lipsticks, like, in fall, period. Especially this gloss. This gloss is gonna be gone. It's gonna be gone, because I'm a gloss girl, but I'm trying to stay like on the matte side because it's fall. So the final rundown of all these products, should you buy them, should you not buy them? Honestly, girl, it's up to you. If you are a big fan of witches and witch themed items and different things like that, then I would say pick up this collection as well. And especially like if you want good quality products that is witch themed, like, definitely pick it up. Like, I enjoyed them. I can see myself using them again this fall. It's just really, really cute. So yeah, that concludes today's video of the Moonspell collection by Lunar Beauty and Manny Indie Way. If you guys did enjoy this video, then give this video a big thumbs up, and do not forget to hit that subscribe button right before you leave. And with that being said, y'all, I will see y'all in the next video. Bye, guys.